You know, we talk about disruptive innovation here a lot. And for us, disruptive innovation means we have to take risks. We take risks as a company. We take risks as individuals. As individuals, we want people, we want to encourage people to stand up in a meeting and go, hold it. I know it's been done this way for 100 years. I got this new idea and you're going to think I'm crazy. Those are the ones I want. We want to encourage customers and we have to tell us what their problems are. I think like Steve Jobs at Apple, we don't anticipate that customers are going to tell us the product they want. They're going to tell us the slew of problems that they have. And then we can come up with the products that they want. Obviously, from a disruptive innovation standpoint, Steve Jobs is the epitome of it. And Steve is the epitome of it because he got fired for being too innovative and they brought him back and he was still too innovative and it just turned out he was right. He was right all along and they should have listened to him. But it was so innovative that it was disruptive actually to the organization. And finally, he came back with a nearly bankrupt company, and now it didn't matter how disruptive you were to the organization. And, you know, he might not be the gentlest, kindest manager, and it just doesn't matter. He's right 75, 80% of the time, and when he's right big. You know, the iPad is an amazing, you know, an amazing, you know, 22 million sold or whatever it is already. So you have to think that's a once-in-a-lifetime find of a person that is so disruptive and got to be back in a place where they'd let him be that disruptive, regardless of what was going on in the organization.